This week, more stores announced that they're leaving Bayshore Town Center, leaving a lot of people to ask, is this mall in trouble? Can it survive this? So Molly Snyder here now with On Milwaukee. We're talking about the mall's future. I mean, it just seems like every other day we're hearing about more stores closing.
It's true. We had two more that we heard were going to close this week. So that's now two retails. That's Shaw's Jewelers and along with the Spreckers and the Home restaurants and also the American Eagle, which was a huge one. And I don't think that the malls are going to be over. Anyone's going to stop completely going to the mall, even though online shopping is, of course, affecting malls. The reality is that the malls need to reinvent themselves. They need to be a place that is more than shopping, a place where people go for more of an experience than just to shop and eat. And that's where it kind of goes back to a full circle thing, because a few decades ago, or even a couple decades ago, we did go to malls for more reason. There was a ice skating rink in Mayfair. There was even petting zoos. There was, and I'm not saying these are the things that are going to come back to malls, but there was musical acts in the middle of malls. And these are the things that there's going to be more interaction in malls, different stores in malls, different experiences and opportunities. And especially at Bayshore Town Center, where it's now been 13 years since it became a town center. So it's not that the mall is dead. It's that, again, it's time for Bayshore to reinvent itself. And there's a $75 million redevelopment plan on the table. So it'll be interesting to see where they go with this and what they bring to us that's more than a shopping experience.
And do we know yet? Do we have the specifics of what they could be doing?
We don't have any specifics yet, but if we look to other malls in the country, what they've been doing, it's been everything from including gyms to including more of some more local stores and just more of an experience when you go shopping, how you interact, some more maybe seeing like more knowing where your clothing comes from, how it's made, just sort of more of the information that we can get from the internet that we can get now from a store, because the actual bricks and mortar stores can't compete with the convenience of online, but they can compete with the experience. And we still all need, we need people. We need social. You know, for a lot of us, shopping is retail therapy. And that means getting out too and being around other people. And so that's never going to go away. No matter how convenient it is to shop on Amazon, you're never going to feel like you're a part of something or you're interacting with people, obviously. And you're not going to get your steps in that way either.
You're right. That's a good point. And I have to believe, too, the people who just put the corners in recently, I mean, they spent a ton of money on that. And if they thought shopping at a brick and mortar store was dead, that wouldn't be here.
Exactly. I mean, it is it's always been about reinvention. We watch stores turn over all the time. We watch mall concepts turn over all the time. And this is happening a lot right now. And yes, online shopping has a lot to do with it. And it is taking away shoppers from the malls. So the malls now, it's their time to say, well, what is going to make people want to come here for shopping? But what else, you know, besides just shopping and eating? And it's pretty exciting to see. I mean, some of the things we've already seen have been just very practical. Like we've seen, you know, more banks, medical facilities and stuff going into these areas so we can get more done in one space.
All right. Well, I know you'll keep us updated on what happens.
Definitely will.
Thank you for joining us.